everyone. I am Assistant Professor Urmi Shah from ITICT Department of LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. So as we are continuing with the chapter number 4 of Analog and Digital Communication course, that is Angle Modulation. So probably in the previous sessions, we have discussed about the FM modulation technique, phase modulation technique, what are the different types of FM modulation, how the different processes in FM modulation works, that is pre-emphasis and de-emphasis. So all these things we have studied it up till now. Then we have also seen the comparison of three types of modulated signal, that is FM modulation, AM modulation and phase modulation. In today's session, we will be looking upon the FM generation methods, that is how the FM signal is generated based on the various methods used. So that we will be discussing what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, what is the application of FM signal, that we will be seeing in this session. So let's start with this session. So in this session, we are going to cover the following topics. So the first topic is FM generation methods. The second topic is the limitations of direct FM generation. Whenever we are doing direct FM generation, at that time, whatever the limitations we are facing, what are the practical issues we are facing, that we will be discussing in this topic. And the last topic is advantages, disadvantages and applications of FM signal. So these are the topics which we are going to cover in today's session. So let's start with these topics. Basically, FM generation method is classified in this way that there are two ways or two methods of generating the FM wave. Basically, we have direct FM generation and indirect method for FM generation. So these are the two types of generating FM wave. In this type also, we have further classification, that is for generating the indirect method for FM generation, we have Armstrong method, and using direct method, we have reactance modulator and varector diode circuitry. Now, what are the issues falling in direct method that we will be discussing, and why we have overcome those issues and developed or move ahead with the indirect method, that we will be seeing. So this way, there are two ways of generating FM signal, that is direct method and indirect method. In direct method, we have reactance modulator circuitry and varector diode based circuitry. And in indirect method, we have Armstrong based circuitry. So now let's understand how the FM generation occurs. Basically, this is the circuitry for reactance method. Now looking upon the circuitry, you can see that there is AF in input from where the modulated signal will be applied to the transistor circuitry. Now here there is a back-to-back connection of transistor. So it is having a two-stage transistor circuitry, which is applied at the end to the oscillator circuitry. This oscillator circuitry is going to provide the final FM output. So this way, the whole reactance method works for generating the FM modulation signal. So now once you have passed your signal through reactance method, there are chances of loss or drop of signal anywhere due to so much complex circuitry, and we have a single power supply, so there might be chances that there is a drop in any one of the circuit block. So now let's understand the next circuitry block. This is about the reactance method. By performing the reaction between these circuitry blocks, we will have the final FM output. Now the next kind of method is based on varector diode modulator. In varector diode modulator, we have a RFC, that is radio frequency coil. From this radio frequency coil, our FM modulating signal input will enter into the varector diode. This diode is nothing but a varector diode. In this diode, varector diode, there is a characteristic that after a diode, we have a capacitor type symbol. So this varector diode is also known as varicap diode. In this varector diode, we will have our input of modulating signal, which is coming from RFC coil to voltage divider circuitry, that is having R1 and R2 resistor, and it is going to come into a varector diode. Now this diode is going to charge whenever the voltage across the anode portion of diode is greater than the cathode portion of diode. Otherwise, it will be in reverse bias mode. So whenever the diode is in forward bias mode, the capacitor C2 attached with the diode is going to charge. And whenever the diode is in reverse bias mode, at that time capacitor is going to be discharged. So it is going to generate a signal in form of charging and discharging of signal in positive and negative wave. So this is how the varector diode modulator circuitry works, and then it will be passed to LC circuit, which is nothing but a filter circuit which is going to provide the oscillation, and then it is going to provide the FM output. So this way the varector diode modulator circuit works based on the concept of varector diode. It will be charging the capacitor whenever the diode is in forward bias mode, and it will be discharging the capacitor whenever the diode will be in reverse bias mode. So this way we will have the generation of FM signal using the varector diode. Now next, let's understand what are the limitations or what are the practical issues whenever we are dealing with these direct method of FM generation. So basically we have listed over here, there are two issues due to which we cannot use direct method for FM generation, or due to which we need to shift from direct method to indirect method. So the first issue is, in this method it is very difficult to get high order stability. In direct method of FM generation, it is very difficult to achieve or get higher order stability in carrier frequency, because in this method the basic oscillator circuitry is not a stable oscillator as it is controlled by the modulating signal. So the circuitry used for these oscillator or this FM generation technique is not a stable oscillator circuitry. So random fluctuations will be there in generating the FM signal using this method. Then the next point of limitation is, generally in this method we will get a distorted FM due to the non-linearity of varector diode. Varector diode is a non-linear device. It is not going to produce every time a linear output. So because of these two reasons, we cannot prefer direct method for FM generation. So facing these limitations, we are going to move now to the indirect method of FM generation, that is Armstrong method. Armstrong is a scientist who has developed these FM generation method, and in this method we can have indirect generation of FM signal. So how this process is going to work, let's understand. Basically, it is going to start from the audio equalizer. In audio equalizer, we will have our audio frequency input. From equalizer, it will go to the balance modulator. In balance modulator, we will have the balancing of phase of the audio frequency input. These equalized audio will go to the balance modulator. In balance modulator, once it is shifted by 90 degree phase shift, the carrier signal is going to enter with 90 degree phase shift, and then we will have only the side bands of these modulating signal which will be applied to the combining network. In combining network, we will have again the carrier signal mixing, and over here these combining network is going to have a signal from buffer, where from buffer we are having the crystal oscillator input. So from these combining network, we will have the further passage of signal into the group of multiplier. Here the FM wave is having very low frequency of carrier. After multiplier block, it will have some medium frequencies as it has been multiplied with the frequency ranges. At the mixer block, it will be multiplied with the crystal oscillator input. That crystal oscillator output, whenever it mixes with a medium level of signal frequency, at that time again we are passing it to the multiplier block. Now this class C power amplifier is going to have the input as high frequency input. These high frequency input will go to the class C power amplifier. Class C power amplifier is used because it is having the highest efficiency from all power amplifier circuitry. We have class A, class B, class AB, class C amplifiers in power amplifier category. But why we are using class C power amplifier over here? Because it is having the highest efficiency among all amplifiers. So that why we are using class C power amplifier, and the input which has been processed in the class C power amplifier will further go as an output to the transmitting antenna. The transmitting antenna will have the signal which is having high frequency and modulation index. So this way the FM transmitter or FM generation method, that is the Armstrong method, works. Indirect generation of method we call as Armstrong method. This way this indirect method of generation works. The IC which is available in market for these basic frequency modulator is based on the NE566 voltage control oscillator. So this IC is used in market for generating FM signal. We will have the modulating signal as input. This IC will be converting the input into the FM output. This way the market FM generation is done using IC566, and these IC566 is having NE566 voltage controlled oscillator, that is nothing but the VCO. Now what are the advantages of FM? Why we have used this FM generation? Because the transmitter power remains constant in FM modulation. Then the FM receivers are immune to noise. Then we have a good capture effect in FM modulation, and there is no mixing of signal using FM modulation. So following are the reasons or the advantages why we are using FM modulation. Next is the disadvantages of FM. Obviously this signal or this modulation technique will have lots of disadvantages, as we are compromising a lot of things and we are moving towards the betterment compared to amplitude modulation, phase modulation. So the disadvantages of FM signal are: it uses too much spectrum space. Now too much spectrum space is related to the frequency spectrum. Then the bandwidth is also larger. We will have a wider bandwidth in FM. So requirement of large bandwidth is a drawback. But if you want to transmit for higher frequency range, then this is the only option. The modulation index can be kept low to minimize the bandwidth use. Then, the reduction in modulation index reduces noise immunity. If I am reducing the modulation index, noise immunity will reduce, so it will have interference of noise in our output of FM modulation. This is used only at higher frequency. So whenever we are working at higher frequency, only at that time this is valid. Otherwise, we have to go for some other technique. So these are the limitations or drawbacks of FM modulation. Now, moving ahead, we have the applications of FM. What are the applications of FM signal? So basically, these are the applications of FM, that it is used in FM radio broadcasting, it is used in sound transmission in television, it is used by police officers as a wireless system. So these are the following applications of FM modulation technique. So here we are completing our FM modulation by learning the techniques of FM modulation, by learning the mathematical form of FM modulation, why it is used, what are the advantages, disadvantages, how it is generated. So this is all about FM. Thank you very much for watching this session. In the upcoming session, we will be moving ahead with a few more topics of angle modulation technique. Thank you so much.